actually off toward the west. Right now, our far southwestern counties under a severe thunderstorm warning. Again, moving through Nebraska City this morning, this line of showers and storms have been progressing through parts of Nebraska this morning and holding together as they generally pull toward the east about 40 to 45 miles per hour. So it's been a very wet start off toward the west. Now, the metro area, we had a few showers earlier today and a few rumbles of thunder, but right now it's fairly quiet. You can see cloud cover is pretty expansive. It's actually a chilly start to the day. We're in the mid 50s right now. Maybe you need to throw on the light jacket when you head out the door and grab the rain gear, because that rain is going to be making its way in here in the next couple of hours. As you can see, it's pretty expansive moving into part of western Iowa right now. These storms brought some heavy rainfall into parts of Nebraska around Omaha, and they do have that flash flood warning that will continue there. Again, the far southwestern part of the state is under that severe thunderstorm warning. So again, mainly to the north, Fort Dodge to Storm Lake Carroll, it's more of a steady rain event. May hear some thunder from time to time, but really it's the southern edge of this line that's giving some trouble here, and some gusty winds possibly up to around 60 miles per hour with that line as it progresses toward the east. So Clarinda, Bedford, be on the lookout for that. We'll see if this gets expanded, that severe thunderstorm warning by the National Weather Service there, in addition to very heavy rainfall and some hail. So there's going to be two rounds of storms. Number one will be this morning, and then as we get into the lunchtime frame, midday will be mainly dry. I think we'll get a break from some of this before the storms redevelop by late afternoon and this evening. And those storms could become strong and even severe. So again, the first round comes through this morning. There's your midday. Still can't roll out maybe a few showers, but again, we'll have a bit of a break from the intensity. And then as we get into the late afternoon, that's when we're going to start to see more storms firing up, and some of those could become strong and severe. And the main threat will be some gusty winds and some hail, and there could be an outside chance of a tornado. Now, as we look at the timeline, again, this is going to most likely affect your evening commute. So just prepare for that. Maybe you want to leave a little bit early if you're looking at your weather app and see these storms really building, just to get home before all this really hits, because most likely we'll see some flash flooding with this because the rainfall will be heavy. This will continue to pull toward the east overnight tonight. Even tomorrow morning, going to stay unsettled. Now, the severe threat ends tomorrow, but still can't rule out a few isolated storms as we get into the afternoon. We may even get an isolated strong storm out of this as well, mainly north of Interstate 80. Today it's mainly Interstate 80 and points south that's under that enhanced risk of severe weather, and then a slight risk up to the north. So again, this is going to be late afternoon, early evening. All modes of severe weather are possible with this later today, so just be aware of that. Make sure you have that weather app handy and your weather radio. Again, tomorrow, isolated storms possible. A few showers there on Thursday, and then Friday we dry out. Saturday, another system moves in, could bring some more storms, and then Sunday and Monday look mainly dry right now, but Tuesday looks unsettled with a temperature near 80 degrees.